She was one of the original 90s supermodels with a rock star husband and the world's best hair. But fast forward to today, New Zealand's most beautiful export, Rachel Hunter, is leading a very different life. She's back at home in LA after being stuck in lockdown in an Indian ashram. And she joins us now. Great to see you, Rachel.
Lovely to see you too. Lovely to see you.
Now, we mentioned your hair in the intro, so I'm just going to go there quickly. You've got your beautiful natural curls on today, but of course, you were famous for saying it won't happen overnight, but it will happen.
It will happen. I know. And still, it's funny because in different scenarios that thing comes up, even recently. So anyway, yeah.
Oh, we're looking at that fabulous hair.
Shot over in Australia, yeah.
I think that phrase will follow you forever. But you are now a yoga and meditation teacher. What led you to this new career? Was it a spiritual awakening, or was it always kind of part of your life?
It was always a part of my life because of my mum. And my mother passed away 3 years ago, and I was taking her through, going through that process of nursing her through the cancer. And eventually when she passed, I was like, how am I going to, go in and help understand this grief? And I had always wanted to go to India after filming Tour of Beauty there. And so I took myself, I kind of Googled a yoga school and was like, okay, I'm just going to go to India and see kind of what the asanas are. And away I went. Little did I know there was just this whole unraveling that occurred there. And I continued to go there for 3 years. But mum was always, she was always curious with spirituality. So it was either Buddhist religion, Christian, born again Christian, so we were always around that. And there was one thing that I said to my mum in her last stages when I was lying in bed with her. I said, what do you regret? And she goes, not fully stepping into who I am and never apologizing for that. And, that's what came up. And it was one of those ah moments. Mm. And that was, yeah.
So, Rachel, going to India was your awakening and stepping back to who you really want to be or were?
Yeah, exactly. I love that you said that word, because I think that we all are who we are. Sometimes, though, for my circumstance, you kind of get in your own way. And I think people go, well, you are that way. And it's not that this is just my experience I'm talking about in regards to this, is everybody is spiritual. No one suddenly becomes spiritual. We all have different connections of what spirituality means, whether it's your love of nature or your love of connecting to people, whatever it is, it's there. It just doesn't kind of come out of, an odd part of you. It is always there. And that may be fully living in who you are and what you celebrate and your job and your loving and your, So it's a essence, there. And yeah, it was surprising because I just went to learn the asanas there and I just kept going back. Hence why I ended up there in February.
Because you were in lockdown there. How long were you trapped in India?
I wasn't trapped.
How long were you insisted that you stayed a prolonged period of time because there was a pandemic going?
It was so amazing. I went down to the south of India and I was actually up in the north and I travelled down to the south because a friend of mine was getting married and I had decided to stay on in Sadhguru's ashram to continue some silence. And that was about 18 days of silence. Now, I knew the pandemic, there was a virus around. And I, around day 18, 19, I was like, I don't know. I just kind of was like, I need to come kind of out of this. And within, I would say about 3 or 4 days from that, that's when the airports closed down. So I was very fortunate to be where I was. And it was a place of course, my children, there was that moment of my kids are, even though they're, 27 and 24, of what's going to happen. And that's the thing with this is it's consistently takes that control out of us, usually we can get up and do things that we want to do if we need to leave or we need to go visit. And in this circumstance, I couldn't leave. So it was a journey definitely that kind of unraveled a lot of stuff. And it was 6 months later I ended up leaving. And I really felt sad leaving because it had really taught me a lot of things. Obviously, in all of these situations, in all countries, there are people that have a really hard, it's very, very confronting. And I was very lucky to be where I was.
Yeah. You mentioned your kids. Yeah. They're young adults now, of course, with your former husband, Rod Stewart. Do you look back on those days when you were, wife of a rock star, living the model life and all of that, to where you are now? Do you prefer this sort of life now? Do you feel this is kind of where you're meant to be? Or how do you look back on those days, and would you have done anything differently?
Never. I love it all. And I love, and that's the thing is, like, yoga and all of this kind of stuff still makes me like that really adventurous, fun-loving, I love being fun-loving. I love going out, having a fun time. So I would never change anything that I did. And during these times in the last 6 months, you really look back and you go, you look back at those days and you go, wow, they were such amazing times, which I think we can all reflect on now in the certain circumstances.
But do you think you could ever...
how lucky we were.
Could you ever have been a spiritual now with your former husband, Rod Stewart? Was he a spiritual person?
But I think he is, because look at the way he performs. Look at the way he loves his audience. Look at the way he, if that's not somebody who still celebrates life fully, and I guess that's my viewpoint on that. He is in full, he is who he is fully. And
you've got a great relationship still.
Yeah, he's amazing. He's amazing, and he's a great dad. And I was very lucky that, Renee and Liam were in London, where he and Penny were during that time of the lockdown, because he was there, with them. And so that was I was very thankful to that. Because, in your mind, your kids are still 10 years old. They're not 27 and 25. Yeah.
They always
will. There's the family photo.
Oh, wow, look at all of those. Wow.
It's like a football team.
That is great. But what a great example of co-parenting and getting on and all of that. Just terrific example. You've also travelled the world for your show Tour of Beauty, which you mentioned earlier. I'm dying to know, you look so fantastic there with your beautiful curls. Have you picked up any amazing beauty remedies or beauty techniques from around the world that you can share with us that are, your little secrets you've picked up?
It was more, and we're seeing this in most of how we eat. People talk about inner beauty and all of that, which we're all pretty much aware of. I would say just that the eating, and of course that's really become in the forefront in the last, 5 or 6 years, but what we eat, who we, our skin being our biggest organ, like how do we take care of it?
How do we take care of it, Rachel? Give me the answer to that one. How do we take, I know how we eat and how not to eat too much, which clearly you don't eat too much. How do we take care of our skin?
Do you know what? When I was in India, I ran out of products. And I'll tell you, the way we were eating, I never needed, and because of the climate and because of the way things are done there, I wasn't using anything at that particular time, because, where was I going to get it? So it was really, it was interesting to see that process, but it's a mixture of everything, right? What you put on your skin, as natural as possible. Of course, some people, if you want to use something, go use it. There's no rules. It's what makes you happy and makes you feel, fully who you are, and whatever that is, there's no judgment of it, that's for sure.
Well, Rachel Hunter, it has been such a delight to catch up with you. Thank you so much for joining us today.
I just want to send so much love to Victoria and to people like Alex. Like, those are the people, that human connection and what they're doing. It's just incredible. And just send you all lots of love.
Lovely thing to say. Thank you.
Yeah, that's beautiful. Yeah. Right back to you too, Rachel. Thanks so much.
Yeah, you too. Take care, guys. Look after yourselves.